Increasingly, there is a two-way investment story, with Australian businesses finding a way to expand into the American market. With the acquisition of the fourth largest brickmaker in the US, Australian company Brickworks is an excellent example of the growing narrative.
Well, I mean, we got to the point in Australia we couldn't grow. You know, there wasn't any market left for us. And so we looked at what the options were as far as expanding overseas. And when we evaluated all the potential brick markets, so we want to be in the brick business, America was the clear number one country that we wanted to come to. It's the largest brick market in the world, nearly 5 billion bricks sold per annum. It has people that speak the same language, same heritage, same culture as ourselves. So we knew we'd get on there. They're very similar laws. But there was a couple of things that really clinched the deal. One was the tax rates and the ability to write off investments immediately once they're made. The second was the low gas prices. And thirdly, we had a couple of suppliers here and we knew the market pretty well, so we knew our way around the United States.
Now, just getting back to your business in the US, what is the rough size of it in terms of employees and turnover, a kind of in the context of your global operation?
Yeah, we've got 800 employees in the United States. We've invested to this point in time about $200 million. We're producing sort of in the circa 300 to 400 million US bricks a year, and we've got capacity to do about 600 million in total.
What do you see as the future of Brickworks in the US?
Look, I think our future is very bright. We're seeing a lot of the trends in the US the same as what we've seen in Australia. People like houses over apartments. They want regional areas over cities. There's a housing boom well and truly underway. People realise they can work from anywhere, so might as well work somewhere they like, where maybe the housing's cheap and more affordable. And this is really driving some demand, and we expect this will continue for quite a few years, particularly with the low interest rates. And at this point, there's no reason why they won't persist.
You mentioned the housing boom in the US. So because of the orders around the country here, you must have a reasonable idea of where people are moving in the US. So what are you seeing in that regard?
Texas. They're coming from the east and the west of Texas. And we're backing up one of the manufacturers from this plant here. We're backing up one of the major producers in Texas who's got 6 months deliveries. And we're pouring, 100,000 bricks a day into Texas.
And just thinking of back home for a second, is the same sort of phenomenon occurring there as well in terms of movement throughout Australia?
Yeah, look, there's no doubt that people are going to move out of Victoria. I think they're tired of being locked up. And we shift product around up and down the coast all the time. We can't shift product really from east to west because of the cabotage on the domestic shipping, which is a big disadvantage for us. But we do move product, and I think we're going to see a greater trend of people moving into Queensland from Victoria, definitely in the regional areas. You get 3 or 4 hours out of Sydney, there's virtually not a house available for sale.
Just in terms of the orders that you're seeing back home, have you seen evidence of that yet, or this is just your assumption going forward?
I know, we're definitely taking the orders and we're delivering increased product into those regional areas for sure.